Yeah, plays a role in stoking racial hatred in this country.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Not just in football. And I think Raheem should have widened it to not just talk about the perception that we have over footballers, just as that article portrays, but also generally speaking, when we hear about Muslim terrorists and Nigerian conmen and Yardi drug gangs and Muslim grooming and pedophile gangs, whereby there are many more white pedophiles, white drug dealers, than there are of the other group of people, but we don't hear we don't talk about that. Now, what that does, it is not targeting, or it's not painting a negative image of drug dealers or a negative image of pedophiles. It's portraying a negative image of Muslims or of Nigerians or of Yardies, and it is a very subliminal, subtle way of indoctrination, because I have an argument with and I've had it for many, many years, as to whether the media influences society or it's a reflection on society. And in more often than not, it influences society. Something which you may think is completely unrelated is Brexit, because we have been influenced, not just the people who voted Leave, but the people who voted Remain, based on the rhetoric that we heard, which influenced us one way or the other. So we are definitely influenced by what we actually see. So when Raheem talks about, which is very, very good, because then we can't just label it to football, because racism is a problem in society, and we can't compartmentalize it to say it's in the police or it's in football, because it absolves the rest of society, in terms of looking at itself, to then say, how culpable are we in being part of this? And we all are.
Do you think, then, it's something that's getting worse?
It's not getting worse, but because we didn't hear it, we thought it was getting better.
Right.
Now, in football, what football can do is they can say, if there are any racist chanting, we're going to kick you out to the ground. So for any unconsciously racist football fans, all you have to do is keep your mouth shut. That doesn't mean it's getting any better. Mm. But of course, in times of confrontation, you saw with Raheem, people show their true colors. And people say, so you can't tell me those three people who actually were racially abusing him, there would have been hundreds who probably would have felt like saying the same thing, but they didn't. Mm. So does that then mean it doesn't exist? So until we start to challenge, to tackle it holistically, looking at how to get rid of racism, and the only way we can do that, is to tackle the cause, not the symptom. And that incident is the symptom of it, as is we've seen symptoms from Luis Suarez, John Terry. We've seen so many symptoms. And very much like a disease, you have to tackle the cause of racism, not the symptoms. And all we're doing is tackling the symptoms.
So going back to the time where bananas were thrown on the pitch when you were playing football, do you think that even though football maybe has tidied up its image a little bit, society still has those same sort of issues to wrestle with?
Well, before we are members of any football fraternity, we're members of society, so we're doing it the wrong way around. You can't look at football, because for football, for 90 minutes on a Saturday, or obviously football is played at different times now, you can't just say because for the 90 minutes we don't see it anymore means it doesn't exist in society. It is prevalent in society as you're going to the inner cities and see how disenfranchised and how lack of opportunities are there for members of ethnic minorities. So why should football be any different?
We've heard, because of what happened to Raheem, Robbie Earle and Jason Roberts both saying that they feel like they've failed Raheem Sterling. What are your thoughts on that?
First of all, they haven't failed Raheem Sterling because there's nothing they can do to change it. Society has to change. They can't change society. Society has to change. And the only way we can do that is, and I always say this, for every Raheem Sterling, John Barnes, who may talk about how we were racially abused, for every Stormzy who says that singers won't get Grammys, and for every Idris Elba or black actors who say we're not getting Oscars, what about the average black person in the street? And until we change the perception of the average black person in the street, there will always be the opportunities for the so-called superstar black celebrities to get an Oscar and to get a manager's job and to get a... But that won't change. The only way we can change racism is if we change the perception of the average black person in the street, and then you will have many more average black people being given what they deserve.
So in terms of those newspaper headlines and those stories that Raheem Sterling was specifically talking about, you talk about changing society. What can the newspaper industry, and not just the newspaper industry, but the media in general, what sort of things would you like to see in terms of the changing of those narratives? And is that a long-term process, or can that change?
It's a very long-term process. We're talking about hundreds of years of indoctrination in ensuring that there are certain groups of people who are more worthy than others. I'll give you an example. I don't really want to talk about this particular person in a bad light, or it's obviously not a different channel, but this is just the principal, Piers Morgan. And I don't know Piers, and I'm sure he's a very, very nice man, but the character of Piers can only be for a white middle-class man who will be successful on television. If it was a woman with Piers' character, that would not be acceptable. Or if it was a black man, it would not be acceptable. Because people may say he's belligerent, people may say that he's condescending, but he's accepted because he's a white middle-class. Now, it's going to take a long time to change perceptions of different groups of people, but we know the group who is completely accepted no matter what happens. Mm-hmm. We know who that is. And the discrimination affects women, it affects ethnic minorities because it's a perception of that person's capabilities. Now, for a woman to lead, for a black person to think, for a homosexual to fight in a war, these perceptions or misconceptions we've had over hundreds of years. And we can't change it by just all of a sudden coming together and saying, you know what you've learned and what has been instilled in you for hundreds of years? That's wrong because we're all equal. It's not as simple as that.
Can I ask you a question? And I accept this from a white man asking a black man this question. When you get asked questions about something completely different, does that thought, which you've articulated so well, does that underlie everything you think? Because you feel that there is a sort of a system which is sort of almost fighting against you in some ways.
In many respects, I'm not talking about me personally.
Because No,
but this is the point I'm making. Because John Barnes is fine, and so is Beyonce, and so is Obama, and so is black people in the higher echelons of society. Mm. But I'm talking about, and I understand what black people go through. So when people talk about, oh, isn't that terrible what happened to Raheem Sterling? I cannot believe that this is happening this day and age. You speak to black people in the cities and they say, this is what we go through every day. Mm. It's not a surprise to us. Mm. So when people are talking about, we thought this already gone away because it doesn't affect you. So very much when, even from a black perspective, we're talking about discrimination. We're talking about it from a black perspective. But women go through discrimination. They're talking about it from a female perspective. LGBT, homosexuals, it's all discrimination based on the misconception we have of those particular groups. And what I'm talking about is looking at it holistically rather than just saying, oh, it's a problem in football. It's a problem for women in business. It's a problem for homosexuals in the army. It is a problem of changing perceptions. And those perceptions are fueled by the media, as Raheem says. But don't just limit it to the way the perception we have over young black footballers, the perception we have over different groups generally.
Fascinating to talk to you this morning. You said when you came on, how long have you got? I wish we had an hour because it's really interesting to talk to you, John. Thank you so much for coming on and sharing your views with us this morning.
Yeah, thanks very much, John. And I'm sure lots of people will have thoughts on that as well. So do let us know what you think. It's